As Gonta Igarashi and his classmates plan for a class trip to Dead Man Wonderland, a privately owned prison that also serves as an amusement park, a mysterious red man appears, killing his entire class and thrusting a red stone into Gonta's chest. Being the only survivor out of the entire class, Gonta is charged with mass murder, and due to the overwhelming and doctored evidence against him with no way to prove his innocence, he is sentenced to death and sent to Dead Man Wonderland's prison. As some of the higher-ups plot to kill Gonta in an accident, Gonta meets a strange white-haired girl named Shiro, who manages to read his heart and understand him. When a bunch of bullies start attacking Gonta and Shiro, an explosion causes a large object to fall towards Gonta. However, Gonta's desire to keep living so he can kill the red man activates the powers that were implanted in him, allowing him to control his blood to save himself as well as Shiro. Gonta learns from a fellow inmate, Yotakami, that in order to have a decent meal in the prison, he needs to earn caste points. He learns of a dog race in which he can win a big prize, which he and Shiro decide to enter. In the locker room, they encounter a fierce inmate named Kazumasa Kazuji who drives fear into the others until Makina, the prison warden, silences him. Gonta soon learns that in order to avoid being killed by a poison, he needs to eat an antidote known as candy, which was secretly stolen from his bag by Yo the other day. Gonta realizes that in order to survive, he needs to win the race in order to purchase a new one, but he soon learns the course is littered with actual death traps. Thanks in part to Shiro's innocent manner, Gonta and Shiro make it to the final stage against Kazumasa, where they have to hold onto a ball and avoid falling into a spike pit. Gonta decides to stand up to Kazumasa, who eventually falls to his death. In the closing moments of the round, Gonta is forced to sacrifice the ball and the prize money in order to keep Shiro from falling and keep their promise of eating the runner-up prize together. Put in charge of observing him by the promoter Tsunenaga Tamaki, Yo gives Gonta a piece of candy so he can keep living, unaware that Yo is putting him in his debt. Meanwhile, the red man, now known as the Wretched Egg, breaks loose and appears before Gonta. Then Gonta tries attacking the Wretched Egg using his own abilities, but the Wretched Egg escapes not long before Gonta falls unconscious. After waking up, Gonta hears from the other witnesses that they keep the Wretched Egg locked up in the G block of the prison, so he and Shiro head towards there. Deeming him dangerous, Makina puts the facility on lockdown and sends a fierce security robot after Gonta. As it approaches them, Gonta and Yo follow Shiro into a secret passage leading to the G block. As Shiro confronts the robot, it is destroyed by the arrival of another inmate with the same powers as Gonta. Believing him to be the red man, Gonta attacks the strange inmate known as Senji Kayomesa, but falls at a disadvantage against the blade Senji can form with his blood. After learning the nature of his power called the Branch of Sin, Gonta launches a counterattack. Gonta soon realizes that Senji is not the Wretched Egg, but one of several dead men with the Branch of Sin. Senji tries to attack Gonta again, but finds himself weak against Shiro before a special unit appears, tranquilizing Gonta and Senji and taking Shiro and Yo to an empty corridor. As Gonta is examined, he comes face to face with Tamaki, who reveals he rigged Gonta's jury verdict to get him sent to Dead Man Wonderland before revealing Gonta will face off against Senji in a battle the next day, tempting him with the prospect of coming face to face with the Wretched Egg. As Gonta is tortured with footage of what a carnival corpse entails, Makina decides to confront the chief director concerning the mysteries of G Block. Makina is halted by Chan and In, bodyguards of the chief director, preventing her from entering his office. Gonta is thrust into his carnival corpse match with Senji and is at a disadvantage as his projectiles use too much blood and cause him to develop anemia. As he becomes helpless, he recalls memories of Shiro and manages to stand back up, using the environment to get a hit on Senji. After escaping from the corridor, Shiro and Yo head towards G Block after Yo hears the whereabouts of a woman he is searching for. After Gonta recovers from his victory, he is horrified to find that Senji is forced to have one of his eyes removed as a result of losing. As Yo uses Shiro as a diversion so he can escape on his own, he bears witness to her true destructive ability, as she herself has the Branch of Sin. As Shiro falls unconscious and is picked up by Chan and N while Yo continues his way to G Block, Ganta meets a girl named Minatsuki Takami, another dead man who had killed her abusive father. Ganta offers to help Minatsuki escape, but soon learns she is his opponent in the next Carnival Corpse match. When the match begins, Minatsuki's personality changes completely and attacks with her whip-like branch of sin, revealing she had manipulated him into taking an injury prior to the match. However, Yo appears, revealing Minatsuki to be his little sister, saying that he plans to gain enough cast points to buy her freedom before entering the arena. Minatsuki tries to manipulate Yo against Ganta, but he turns on her instead, having learned the truth behind his father's death. Minatsuki captures Yo and uses him as a human shield against Ganta, revealing she has shown hatred ever since her mother left her for dead during the Red Hole incident. Ganta manages to disable one of her whips and free Yo, before knocking her out with a headbutt, winning the match. After a strange quake occurs during which Yo rushes to keep Minatsuki from harm, Ganta starts to remember things about Shiro, who is revealed to be the Wretched Egg. As Ganta recalls his childhood with Shiro, Yo cannot bring himself to mention what he had seen her do. As Yo goes to recover the casts that were stolen from him, he learns from Tamaki that casts cannot be used to reduce the sentences on G-Block inmates and is attacked by Azuma Jankaku, part of an anti-deadman force known as the Undertakers. Meanwhile, Ganta meets Nagi Kengamin and Kurako Koshio, members of a deadman prison gang known as Scar Chain, wanting to destroy Deadman Wonderland. Nagi and Kurako invite Ganta to join their gang. As Minatsuki goes through her penalty game, Nagi arranges it so that she only loses her hair. Just then, Jankaku appears and attacks Ganta and the others. Ganta is saved by the arrival of Shiro, who is back under control by the lullaby, to which Jankaku decides to retreat. Afterwards, Ganta is introduced to the other members of Scar Chain, who oppose the prison and are plotting to expose Dead Man Wonderland secrets on Inspection Week. Makaina also plans to take advantage of to find out what secrets are being hidden from her. However, Ganta becomes a little distrustful when his claims of his branch of sin being stopped by Jankaku differ from what the security cameras show and takes his leave. Ganta later learns from Senji about how Jankaku killed Nagi's wife, also hearing from Nagi about how each member of Scar Chain has their own ideas of freedom. As Ganta promises to take Shiro on a Ferris wheel when they escape someday, it is shown that one of Scar Chain's members named Bundo Rokuro is a double agent for the Undertakers. Ganta decides to join Scar Chain, who begin their operation to leak information about the dead men to the outside world. As Nagi and Rokuro go to the security room, Ganta and the others are chased by an acid-spewing robot, to which Kurako opts to stay behind to save the others. After recalling the time she joined Scar Chain, Kurako defends herself from the acid-spewing robot and destroys it, falling down with it. Meanwhile, Nagi is betrayed by Rokuro and confronted by an undertaker named Hibana Daida, who uses a special weapon to neutralize his branch of sin. As Hibana starts slicing off bits of Nagi's flesh, he provokes her into chopping off his arm by mentioning of her abusive mother, giving him the opportunity to activate the elevator Ganta's group needs to take. However, Ganta's group is confronted by Jankaku and his men, leaving only Ganta and a few others left alive to carry the chip containing the information. While bleeding to death, Nagi makes a call to the hideout, which is heard by Shiro, who catches up to Ganta and throws the chip into a fire. Ganta becomes angry at Shiro for throwing away the data chip, telling her he never wants to see her again, and proceeded to punch her. Meanwhile, Makaina investigates Tamaki's office, overhearing a conversation between him and the defense secretary concerning the dead men. As Kurako and the others discuss their next plan, Rokuro appears and reveals the data chip was actually a bomb he had made, before announcing that the group is being held hostage unless Nagi agrees to become an undertaker. As Rokuro decides to execute Ganta first, Senji appears on the scene, managing to fight back against the Undertakers using sonic blasts. As Shiro laments her situation with Ganta, she meets Toto Sakigami, the one who told her about the bomb. Detesting his weak self, Ganta asks Senji to teach him how to use his branch of sin to fight. Meanwhile, Kurako attempts to infiltrate the Undertakers by disguising herself as a guard. As Toto appears before Ganta and Senji during their training session, Shiro, who gets drunk off of liquor sweets, appears before Jankaku, who also discovers Kurako. Just as Ganta manages to produce a blood bullet that can break the sound barrier, Jankaku announces his capturing of Shiro and Kurako. Despite being low on blood, Ganta rushes to where Jankaku is keeping them, but is confronted by Nagi, who had been mentally broken by Jankaku and turned into a raging demon. As Nagi goes on a rampage on all the guards, Ganta stands to protect Shiro, taking all of his punches and trying to reason with him. Then, as Nagi starts to come to his senses thanks to the bell Kurako wears reminding him of his friends, Kurako is suddenly stabbed by Jankaku. Nagi stands to protect his friends but is shot by Jankaku, who begins killing the other guards. While Ganta starts being poisoned due to not having any candy in a while, Hibana tries to escape but is killed by Todo, who had managed to obtain Senji's abilities after drinking his blood. As Shiro enters the wretched egg mode, the stone in Ganta's chest glows and blasts a powerful shot, with Nagi holding Jankaku in place as they are both mortally wounded. Before dying, Nagi gives Ganta his last piece of candy. As Kurako and some others escape, Ganta decides to stay behind so he can protect his friends. Todo becomes fascinated with Ganta's branch of sin, eager to know how it tastes. At the end of the episode, Shiro sings a lullaby to Ganta, who remarks that he last heard the lullaby just before his classroom was attacked by the red man. So this is the end of anime. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoyed it.